I'm Associate Professor Frank Bruno, and I'm an Associate Research Professor at the Barbara Hardy Institute at the University of South Australia. Yeah. One of my areas of research interest is low-cost energy storage, and that's using phase change materials to store thermal energy, which is heating and cooling. So it not only involves the development of these materials, the phase change materials, but also the system which contains the materials and also which takes the heat in and out of these materials. Another area of research interest is the energy in buildings. It's actually reducing the energy associated with air conditioning the buildings. So with thermal storage, we have developed a technology applicable for refrigeration and air conditioning systems. These thermal storage systems can be incorporated with the conventional refrigeration and air conditioning systems. They can be charged up during the night when the electricity is generally cheaper and more available, and then during the day the cooling can be used. Also, thermal storage can also be used in solar power plants, and that's subject to future research. In regards to buildings, we have been involved in developing guidelines for Australia's leading national green village, which is Lochiel Park, located in Adelaide. We've made recommendations on how energy can be reduced in the homes and the use of energy efficient appliances, and also the sizing of solar PV systems. I've also led the national testing program for Sealy International to test their climate wizard, which is a dry evaporative cooling system. This system delivers dry, cool air, and it's I showed that in certain situations it's more efficient than the conventional refrigeration systems. This system is now, Sealy International now manufactures the system in Adelaide. I have also been involved in numerous air conditioning monitoring projects. One of the recent ones has been in collaboration with MS Australia, where we proved that people with MS require more cooling as a consequence of their medical condition. Now, these results will be used for future policy work to help these people and to give them support in the future. We have developed a number of low-cost materials for storing heating and cooling at low temperatures. And we have also developed the thermal storage systems which contain these materials. And we have developed a new concept known as dynamic melting, which both extends the life of these phase change materials, which stores the energy, and also enhances the responsiveness of these systems. Now, this system has been commercialised by an Australian company, Quickcore Cooling Technologies, and the first commercial plant is now in operation on a farm on the outskirts of Adelaide. It utilises over 300,000 kilograms of phase change materials, which is under licence from the University of South Australia. Our future focus will be to develop these phase change materials for higher temperature applications, namely for solar power plants. In regards to buildings, I see us heading towards positive energy homes. These are homes which actually generate more energy than consume. In the future, we need to further reduce the cost of thermal storage, and this could be done by using novel materials and novel techniques in thermal storage systems. And also, we need to develop new phase change materials to store the heating and cooling at different at other temperatures, such as for air conditioning, which is the biggest energy consumer. In regarding to buildings, we need better development of insulation so that it performs better once it's been installed. And also, we need to integrate renewable energy devices into the building, and we need further improvements in the efficiency of air conditioning systems. For those people considering following the path of sustainable energy in research, I can say that this is a growing and very exciting area of research. Within 10 years, we'll be seeing a big shift from energy sources from the conventional fuels to clean energy sources being obtained from renewable energy sources, being obtained from solar and wind. There'll be many jobs created in this field. And I'm sure we'll see many new inventions and innovations.